On the news hour tonight, I'm joined by Shailesh Gandhi, retired former CIC and well-known RTI activist, T.R. Raghunandan, advisor of the Accountability Initiative, Sanjay Bhus Reddy, president of the IAS Officers Association. He's joining us from Delhi, T.S.R. Subramaniam, former cabinet secretary. This is on one side. On the other side, the political side tonight, I am joined by Gaurav Bhatia of the Samajwadi Party, Rahul Narvekar of the NCP, Brajesh Kalappa of the Congress Party, Sambit Patra of the BJP. But I'd first like to go across to RTI activist Ganesh Kondilya, who's joining us from Bengaluru. Ganesh, can you hear me? Good evening. You have said, Ganesh, that you know, you have said that DK Ravi was on the verge of revealing more information and taking some more action, which could have cost hundreds of crores to build a lobbies. Can you tell us more about what DK Ravi was working on?
See, we had a conversation on Thursday. Right. Last Thursday, wherein like he wanted me to work with him, coordinate with him in his effort to recover more tax evasions by more prominent developers. And in that connection, you know, he wanted me to meet him this week so that he wanted some information regarding several other developers, wherein he wanted to recover the tax evasion amount for the government.
So when was the last conversation that you had with him, Ganesh?
Last Thursday.
And you were going to give him some papers?
Four or five days back.
No, so you were going to give him some papers, some more evidence which he could have used to act against some developers in Bengaluru?
Exactly, based on my revelations and fight against this house building cooperative societies, there were income tax raids wherein about 475 crores has been recovered by income tax. And there has been also service tax evasions and stamp duty evasions.
Sure.
In the same line, he wanted to find out this commercial tax evasion also.
So this, there's a land mafia working there, right? Do they work independently or under the patronage of politicians?
See, absolutely, there is a collusion by each and every department. All our complaints go absolutely a waste. It has not been inquired into properly. For example, there is an inquiry ordered for this stamp evasion before 1.5 years, and still there is not a single movement has happened apart from notices being served.
So only notices are served and then there is no action. So the problem happens if an honest officer comes into the system and actually wants to act, because sometimes dishonest officers serve notices because they want bribes in turn. But when an honest officer comes in, he wants to move beyond the next step. You told me that you spoke to him on Thursday. How long was your phone conversation with DK Ravi? How long did you two talk about?
It was hard. It could be for about 78 minutes because we are supposed to meet, you know, this week. We have fixed that we are meeting this week and sharing information and so working together towards the recovery.
So you were going to meet him this week?
Yeah, very much.
Because when I spoke to some reporters,
I was supposed to meet him today or tomorrow.
Some reporters told me that last week he was talking about how in 1 or 2 weeks he was going to take the next step and expose many other tax violations. So all of this adds up. He was obviously depending on the information you would give him to maybe take the next step against this mafia.
100%. He wanted the information precisely because he has raided some people for whom, you know, like I have papers in connection with the house building cooperative societies, which he found out. And he wanted more information to be this thing revealed to him. Subsequent to, there are some income tax raids and, you know, like service tax raids has already happened. In the same line, he wanted this commercial tax evasion also to be unearthed.
Can you believe the man like this can commit suicide?
Impossible. See, he is a man of valor, bravery, and he was very enthusiastic when he spoke. He was excited. He was looking forward. There was nothing, not even an iota of indication that he will bog down to any pressure. And let me tell you, Mr. Goswami, even if the claims of suicide to be believed, there is nothing called suicide. If he is killed himself, there is an enormous pressure put on him. Even that amounts to murder, and we need the complete truth. And if the government is serious about it, what is the hesitancy for them to give it to CBI?
No, they, you know, that is this government actually.
If there is nothing to hide.
Just 1 minute. You see, first of all, I refuse to believe that that he committed suicide. Yeah, you know, you can kill a person and make it look like suicide. There is no suicide note which has been got in this case. I don't know why both the Home Minister of Karnataka, the Bangalore Police Commissioner seem to be jumping the gun on suicide. I mean, there is no evidence that it is suicide. If here is a person, from all available accounts, Ganesh, when he speaks to you, he is interested in data, information. If he were to commit suicide, he would not commit suicide without revealing the reasons for his wanting to do so. There is no apparent reason. There is no suicide note here. I mean, if he was a man, young man, absolutely, determined to take on the system, why would he kill himself without revealing those who were putting pressure on him? This appears to me to be a case.
Absolutely.
You know, how do they say it's prima facie suicide? I can't believe it, Ganesh. I just can't believe it listening to you tonight.
No. Let me tell you, Goswami, even before the postmortem or the investigation has begun, not even come to any this thing, even if it's begun, the FIR is filed under section 174 of CRPC, which indicates that it's suicide, and they've already come to the conclusion of the FIR that it is for the personal reason. How can they come to a conclusion that it is for a personal
reason? The Home Minister,
even before the postmortem has come in.
That's the Home Minister, by the way, KJ George, who has said that.
Yeah,
that's the Home Minister, KJ George, who said
that. To read in the assembly.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, Mr. Goswami, when he reads that FIR in the assembly, he says that the daughter, that is DK Ravi's wife, goes to her father, the father-in-law of Ravi, on 14-3-2015, and she says that when she made calls, there is no response. Yesterday was 16th. That is the lackluster with which the FIR is prepared. Instead of 16th, they say 14th in the FIR. And how do you believe that this government is going to have an impartial, speedy, genuine inquiry?
Well, I have Mr. Reddi, the police commissioner, on the phone line. I have the police commissioner on the phone line, Mr. Ganesh. Mr. Reddi, are you there?
Yeah.
Mr. Reddi, good evening. Arnab, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here as well. Yeah.
How did this suicide theory get pushed? I mean, just doesn't make any sense.
Arnab, I have visited the scene of crime and examined it along with the police team as well as the forensic team. The forensic experts have conducted detailed analysis of the scene of crime, the nature of hanging, a number of things, of almost 10 parameters.
Is there a suicide note?
Understanding.
Is there
whether,
1 minute. Is there a suicide note?
No, there is no suicide note.
Okay, one minute. Second question. My information is that horde of VVIPs went to his apartment, tainting the entire crime scene. Am I right or wrong?
Now, as far as the crime scene is concerned, it is within a one bedroom.
No. Mr. Reddi, the bedroom, the house is on the 9th floor of an apartment block, right? Fingerprints, strands of hair from unwanted visitors present in the apartment. The whole apartment has been botched up in terms of acquiring forensic evidence. How do you say that you are sure of the evidence that you have?
So you please listen to me. The fact is that as far as the room in which, are you there?
I am very much here.
So as far as the room in which the actual incident has taken place in terms of hanging, that has been secured by the time the police went. Only the family members were there.
Here is an officer. You know that he's taking on the corrupt and the powerful and the builders, and you know that he's a man who is going to expose a lot more in the future. Where have you taken that into perspective?
Yeah, so therefore, just allow me to just complete this part of what I want to say, is that purely based on the scene of crime examination with experts and
sir, you are repeating yourself. Sir, the fact is,
it was a prima facie case of suicide.
Prima facie, you can say whatever. There's no suicide note. As far as I know, the rest of the apartment beyond that one room which you say has been cordoned off, you know, has been botched up in terms of VVIPs just walking in. I don't know how your police allows it. You have jumped the gun by saying there is no room for foul play. All reports
are yet to come in.
Shailesh Gandhi, you're an RTI activist. Does this add up here? Shailesh Gandhi is a well-known RTI activist. He's a former CIC. I don't understand how you can simply say there is no possibility of foul play.
Just a minute.
Ganesh wants to say something to you as well. Ganesh wants to say something to you.
Before that,
one second.
I want to ask the commissioner a simple question.
Go ahead. Ganesh.
I want to ask Ms. M N Reddi a simple question.
Yeah, please tell me.
That how is it that, you know, like even before the beginning of investigation by hearsay, you declare and set the tone and tenure of the investigation as suicide?
Exactly.
And how come that FIR has been filed under 174 and not under 174C? Which at least, you know, like what prompted him to commit the suicide?
Okay, so let me answer your question. The fact is that after conducting the initial examination of the scene of crime, I stated that it was a prima facie suicide, but investigation will continue.
Mr. Reddy, I'm sorry, you are a very experienced police officer. It is my view that by saying so, you were prejudging the case. You should not have done that. My second point is, Mr. Commissioner, please tell me. I don't know whether you are aware that DK Ravi raided a series of establishments, some of which have a link to many senior politicians, ruling party politicians in Karnataka. Are you aware of that?
Yeah. So what I would like to tell you...
No, watch. First of all, I want to ask you, had this officer raided establishments which have links to senior political figures in Karnataka?
Well, the investigation is on about the action he has taken against various people since the time he has taken
over. Okay, let me be very specific. Let me be very specific.
Yeah.
Are you aware of a group called the Embassy Group?
Well, I am aware of the group.
Can you tell me whether the Embassy Group has any business dealings with another company which has links with a ruling party politician in Karnataka?
Well, I mean, Embassy Group, I am aware that they have multiple businesses, and as far as my knowledge goes, the Embassy Group's construction activity is what is one of the groups that has been targeted or raided or identified.
Good. Now tell me, the Embassy Group, there is an IT park Embassy Golf Links, which there is a case of alleged encroachment of defense land. Are you aware of that? The Embassy Group, does it have any tie-up with another group called the Kela Chandra Group?
Yes, there
and
are.
Can you tell me whether any ruling party politician in Karnataka has any stake or shareholding in the Kela Chandra Group?
There could be multiple owners of these.
Suppose it is found today. You see, I'm not linking this to the murder, but what I'm saying is, suppose it is found today that there is a group which has been targeted by this officer, which in turn has a business relationship with another group which is linked to a ruling party politician, then I think the basic question goes, can you trust the Karnataka government? Can you trust the Karnataka government, Mr. Commissioner, with a fair investigation into a case when there are proven links or possible links between?
You can trust me with the investigation.
Sir, I don't know. It's not a question of your saying you can trust me with the investigation. Because KJ George is the Home Minister. Sir, you may be a fine man, but KJ George is the Home Minister. KJ George says the police have found clues that there is a personal angle involved.
Well, I mean, I can say that to you that the investigation, as it has, of course, we have handed over to the CID.
1 minute,
this evening,
please let me listen.
But
I missed you in the last part. 1 minute. No, repeat yourself.
Yeah, we have handed over the investigation to CID as of this evening.
Sir.
But before that, till the time we handed over, the information collected proved to personal angle, which CID will take it forward and take it to the logical conclusion.
How do you come to... you don't look at any other angle. You say, trust me with the investigation. You preempt it saying personal angle. In other words, you are saying that a crusader killed himself. Whereas there is Ganesh. Yeah, Ganesh, do you believe this? Here is a government trying, hell-bent on proving that the man killed himself because of personal angle.
No.
Mr. Reddy, this is a disservice. This is a disservice. You know, a dead man cannot speak for himself. What do you think, Mr. Shailesh Gandhi, it's what's going on? This is a classic case of trying to silence the situation.
It's apparent that there is a great enthusiasm to show that this gentleman committed suicide. which is not possible. Prima facie, why did you not talk of murder, Mr. Commissioner? Instead of suicide, is there anything specific that you found there? Did you find a suicide?
So, if you permit me,
yes, sir.
The nature of the saliva dribbling, the oblique ligature mark, no struggle marks being present, no dust mark on the garments.
Where is the postmortem report? Where is the postmortem report?
Then why do you need a postmortem, sir?
Where is it?
Yeah.
No, where is the postmortem report?
The postmortem report is expected in a couple of days.
No, 1 second, Mr. Reddy. Before the postmortem report goes out, the police commission and the home minister come together and prejudge the case in a public forum. How fair is that? Ganesh wants to ask you something as well. No, sir. I'm telling you. This whole case, and you say there's no room for foul play. Basically, you want to close this case. What did you think, Mr. Commissioner? You thought the media would not follow up this case? You think this is being fair on a crusade every time an honest officer gives up his life? Mr. Commissioner, you answer one question. Why do you not look at the angle of political and corporate and bureaucratic pressure on this officer? How can you not even look upon it?
And all angles will be looked at.
No, but
all
then before they are looked at, why have you prejudged? Before they are looked at, why have you prejudged? Before they are looked at, why have you prejudged, Mr. Commissioner? Why have you prejudged?
Only based on the scene of crime.
No, but on the scene of the crime, before an investigation happens, you prejudge it, your home minister prejudges it?
No, I think this is unfair.
Mr. Reddy, I'm hanging up on this now. I think this is really unfair. Put yourself today, Mr. Commissioner, put yourself in the shoes of that family of that young officer who has fought the system. No ostensible reason for him dying. Any decent police officer anywhere would have said, let me actually assess the other reasons that could be playing on this man. Suppose I tell you now, Mr. Reddy, that there is a person on my program called Ganesh Kondia. Right? Ganesh says that he had received a phone call from this gentleman, DK Ravi, and he was on the verge of giving him information which could have implicated people, leading to hundreds of crores of rupees of tax evasion. Now, that's an angle which could be a motive for murdering him. That's an angle which could be a motive for murder. Do you agree with me or not?
I totally agree.
Then
with you.
Why did you not look?
But
you already judged the case, Ganesh.
No, I have not judged. Because the media are asking me.
Sir, you must understand this, Mr. Reddy. It is in the interest of the political class in your state to silence this case. It is in the interest of the political class. The political class in Karnataka wants to silence this case. Remember this, Mr. Reddy. You too are a bureaucrat, a police officer. You've gone through the system. You have a young officer here. You know his background. In the last 1 year, he did so much good work in Kolar that the politicians could not stand him and they actually forced him to go out. Today, people in Kolar I have not seen have come out in public protest. Here is a 35, 36-year-old officer who was kicked out of Kolar for the good work that he did. He was on the verge of breaking something big. You cannot just prejudge the case. And I'm telling you, Mr. Reddy, the politicians...
You told me I have to leave now.
The politicians... Yes, Mr. Ganesh, you can go. The politicians, Mr. Reddy, will be very happy if you close the case. But people won't.
I'm sure they will take all the...
No, sir. They will take the action now. Let me also see, Mr. Reddy, how many politicians and bureaucrats and policemen, you know, gang up in this case. We'll put our evidence against yours. I hope you'll consider it. Shailesh Gandhi, D.R. Raghunandan, let's open up the debate. What's going on here, Brajesh Kalappa? Would you like to explain?
Yeah, Arnab, first of all, I must point out that... insofar as what you said about the embassy group and the allegations made, these were part of a tweet which a right-wing journalist had put out.
I must inform you,
I have spoken to the Home Minister. Legal action will be initiated against both these persons who tweeted these, because this is a prima facie lie. This is something which cannot be sustained. It's a falsehood. And the Home Minister of Karnataka is going to initiate legal action
against
both those persons who have tweeted that he had anything to
do with
Here
we have the spokesperson of Congress trying to arrest the person who has tweeted something. First, you should be expressing condolence for the person who has left us today, a young, budding, talented officer who was trying to take on people who are corrupt.
I'm sorry, Sambit, because if I heard you, because a right-wing journalist, and you think that supposing there's a right-wing journalist who wants to create mischief, and he wants to show the entire Congress party as being part of some massive conspiracy.
Your opening statement is the government will arrest those who have tweeted.
But I must
you should have opened the statement
truth
by saying that
truth
justice would be done
truth
for those who
truth
are responsible for the death of Mr. D.K. Ravi.
I'm sorry, Sambit, this should have been your opening statement. I'm sorry to be hurting you. But I must point out
why are you hurting me? Every
year,
Indian is hurt.
A case was handed
every
over to
Indian
the
is hurt, Mr. Brijesh Kalappa,
by
your insensibility. Your insensibility hurts every single Indian today.
That case is lying
was
in the court
there, okay,
the
one second, please. Just one minute. Will you please, Brijesh? Brijesh, for God's sake. For God's sake, 1 minute. For 1 minute, just 1 minute. Please understand this. An honest officer dies. You call the case one of suicide. The Bangalore Police Commissioner, before any reports come out, rules out foul play. The Home Minister says it's a case of suicide. Everyone jumps the gun. You know the background of this person, Brijesh Kalappa. What are you complaining about? Okay, Embassy Group, I've heard enough about the Embassy Group. This man also targeted Rajesh Exports, Shubh Jewelers, RMZ Institutions, Prestige Group, Mantri Developers. He had targeted a lot of people. He had prepared...
And they're all close
no,
to the
1 minute, please let me complete
now. You know that
now.
Rajesh Exports is close to the BJP?
He had... What? Who's close to the BJP? Who?
Rajesh Exports is close to the BJP. Are you aware of that?
Well, thank you for telling me now. Then tell me that they are not close to the BJP. We know how many political groups and political parties and business houses operate. But is that the issue?
I think we are deviating from the point. No, by discussing which builder is close to which party.
I am not, you know, on this issue of which builder is close to which politician. Arnab. Let me first say, no, 1 second, Gaurav. I am not interested which group builder is group to which. I am not saying this builder is close to this politician. I'm not saying Embassy Group. No, 1 minute. Embassy Group is close to this politician, or I'm not saying Rajesh Exports is close to this politician. But what I am saying generally is that there is a general view that builders and politicians are close, and that it is damn difficult. It is damn difficult for an honest officer to take on the system. We all know it. After all, Mr. Subramaniam, what is the background of this man, Arvi D.K. Ravi? 35-year-old officer, kicked out of Kolar. What was his fault? He did so much good work. He cracked down on the sand mafia. He stopped the encroachment on government lands. He fought for the citizen. And what did they do? Just a couple of months back, the Congress government threw him out of Kolar. They should have encouraged him to do more work. They should have given him an award. They
not
punished
him. Out. I'm sorry.
What are you talking about?
I'm sorry,
this?
You don't,
have
the facts.
Don't interrupt me again, Brijesh Kalappa.
I'm sorry, you don't have the facts.
I have the facts with me. What you don't
no, no,
have the
please,
facts.
Please, I have to interrupt you.
I have the facts.
Creating something
facts
completely false. I have to interrupt you.
Well, I'll tell you
because you don't know what you're
to
speaking.
Every time I brought
your reporters are not doing a good
you realize what it
then
is. The 36 another officer dies.
Of course, I have to stop you.
Then let me tell you the fact. Then you stop me. D.K. Ravi was Deputy Commissioner of Kolar. He won hearts.
I will tell you the facts.
I'll tell you the facts.
Then you can tell me.
Why are you being so unnecessarily aggressive? Now.
No, I will tell you the facts. You
don't show me your temper, Mr. Brijesh
Kalappa. Please listen to me, Arnab.
He worked.
You're the big brain. I know you're the big brain of everything. But please listen to me for some time.
Mr. Kalappa.
Facts are like this.
Mr. Kalappa, I don't understand what you mean by calling me a big brain. I'm just asking a few facts here tonight.
Our Honorable Chief Minister picked him. Picked him up from Kolar and brought him to his own department, which is the Department of Finance, which is the Prime Chief Minister of Karnataka.
Don't talk rubbish.
Why would he pick up somebody?
Don't talk rubbish.
He's a bad guy.
Don't talk rubbish.
Somebody who's a gem.
Thousands, please.
No, you are talking rubbish.
No, thousands.
You are talking rubbish.
Thousands of people.
You are talking rubbish.
Thousands of people.
No, you see, you have
thousands of
hatred.
I'll tell you the facts now, Brijesh Kalappa.
And you will continue to talk rubbish.
Yes, I will say so.
Because
your father
lost
an election to the Congress party. Case after case.
In 1998, you ran your party against us.
Case after case. Young officers are dying in this country. Don't you get it?
Arnab,
and TSR Subramaniam will come in before that. I'll place a fact. And Brijesh Kalappa, you will not interrupt me this time. He was thrown out of Kolar. He could not complete his work. thousands of people had actually on the 5th of November stormed the Deputy Commissioner's office, saying, let this man continue his work. People
of
Kolar had protested the transfer. They were begging the government that he should be allowed to continue his work for some time. TSR Subramaniam, the truth is uncomfortable, face it.
Arnab, October 1913 Supreme Court order is very, very clear.
No, the truth is uncomfortable to you. No,
but please keep quiet now. You're fair enough. October 13 Supreme Court order is quite clear. It says that minimum 2 years tenure, unless for reasons to be recorded, a person cannot be transferred. Prima facie, there is no contempt of the court. He has been thrown out of a 2 year tenure in contempt of Supreme Court orders. So it is number one. Number two, there is so much of stench in this matter. Whatever be the inquiry, and we know what state CADs are all over India.
Oh, yes, we
know it thoroughly, completely. We know it completely. Do you know a single case which state CADs have cracked all over India? Unless, it's extremely important to know that, that we are not going, unless we find a suicide note, nobody can convince
me. First of all, Mr. Subramaniam, what is very strange is straight away Mumbai Bengaluru police commissioner goes to the spot.
Chief minister telling the foreign sick team. What can, probably all evidence has been destroyed by burning.
Exactly.
That's what happened now.
Exactly. Destroy the evidence.
What has happened now?
Take over the case, put the pressure, please the bosses. Gaurav Bhatia wants to come in. Yes, Gaurav.
Evidence gone now. The evidence has gone.
Yeah. Destroy the evidence.
Arnab.
Yeah.
Arnab, I think it is very clear that there is something foul in this entire case. The commissioner coming out and repeating continuously that prima facie it looks that it's a case of suicide.
Ridiculous.
Then the Home Minister saying that. In fact, it would have been proper had they said that at this stage we would not be commenting since the investigation is on. And look at the double standard of the commissioner. When you asked him about the link between the builders and the politicians, even though the investigation is on, he did not even say prima facie there is a link.
Yeah.
He was quiet then. An investigation is a stage after the registration of FIR. So when it comes to this honest IAS officer, they want to jump to conclusions. But when it comes to the nexus between the politicians and the builder, even after the investigation is over,
like
they do not wish to dwell the details.
Yeah,
now, secondly, they say that CID has been handed over the investigation. CID is another wing of the state government, and there would be no impartial investigation. I think a free and impartial investigation can only take place if there is a special investigating team that is constituted either by the High Court or the Supreme Court, and the state government should not handle this investigation. And thirdly, there is a very strong conspiracy angle here, and this conspiracy angle has not even been touched by the commissioner. I think he has given it away when he doesn't even wait for the post-mortem report.
Exactly.
And he says that it's a case of suicide, and that is why all fingers are pointing towards the Home Minister and the Commissioner of Police. I think he is faulted big time, and it is high time now that an independent probe should be ordered.
Exactly. I don't know why when facts are presented in that manner, Prajesh Kalappa does not find the interest in responding, because he knows his facts are weak. Now, we also know.
Let me tell you this, Arnab.
We also know.
So, insofar as the CBI inquiry is concerned, the state government doesn't have a closed mind. The state government doesn't have a closed mind.
Then hand it over, Mr. Raghunandan. Why
don't
tell you why we are not doing it.
Why don't you want to do it? The truth will come out.
I'll tell you why we are not doing it.
Because the builder politician nexus.
Why as an advocate, you tell me, was it proper for the commissioner to say that prima facie this is a case of suicide? Was it proper for the commissioner and the Home Minister to say that even when the post-mortem report is awaited?
Brajesh Kalappa, one minute. First of all, Brajesh Kalappa, one minute. You heard that silly reply of the commissioner.
And the home minister.
No, no, one second. Shambit, listen here. Shambit, listen. The commissioner is No, one second.
It's not nice when the police commissioner is not on air to say he's a silly man. You should have said it when he was on air.
Mr. Kalappa.
You should have said it when he was on air. Then you want to say he's a silly man.
Mr. Kalappa, I have said silly.
No, but I don't know.
Silly argument, I will say once again.
I will say once again,
it's a silly argument. Now, what I'm saying here is, you are a police commissioner. You're not some Sherlock Holmes that you land on the spot.
You think
the first thing you ask yourself is, where could there be a motive for murder? We present to the police commissioner an obvious motive for murder. Mr. Kalappa, will you have the patience to listen to me? Will you listen to me now, please?
No, no, everybody listens to you every day.
Mr. Kalappa, listen to me.
Everybody is going to make
There is a motive for murder.
Ideally, you should have given me 50
There is a motive for murder. A commissioner does not need to be told about a motive of murder on a TV program.
But you love your voice so much.
A police commissioner cut off all your personal barbs. A police commissioner does not have to be told about a motive for murder on a TV program. Mr. Raghunandan, this is laughable out here. You know, on a TV program, we are presenting a motive for murder and the police commissioner says, yes, it could be that. But Mr. Commissioner, you've already prejudged the case along with your home minister. Is this adding up, Mr. Raghunandan, in this case? Is this adding up?
Well, Arnab, the first point is that as far as this bickering between the Congress and the BJP is concerned, throwing allegations at each other are concerned, it's really pathetic because Bangalore is in the grip of what I call hyper-corruption. There's a well-oiled mechanism of bribe-taking and bribe-giving and bribe-channelizing. And it matters little whether X party is in power or Y party is in power. Only the suitcase delivery changes from one address to the other. Now, the whole point is that what does an honest officer like Ravi do? And what is the kind of stress on an honest officer like Ravi? When Mr. Ravi was transferred from Kolar, since I happened to do some work in Kolar, I had a discussion with him because a lot of my NGO friends in Kolar were up in arms and they wanted to have an agitation. And I called up Mr. Ravi because I said that I will consult him first to understand what he wanted and whether if we do something it would embarrass him or hurt him in any manner. And Mr. Ravi told me, and he was absolutely straightforward, he said, I am packing my bags, I will go wherever the government posts me, and sir, you don't have to do anything for me. I thought that was a remarkable statement. It shows an individual's determination, but it also reveals another very, very sad fact. The fact of the matter is that honest officers in Karnataka are plenty. Courageous officers in Karnataka are not that plenty. And when somebody combines courage and honesty together, life can be very, very, very lonely for that individual. And I do not know, I don't want to jump the gun and say whether it's murder or suicide, but I can just imagine the kind of stress that was on him. And I believe that we have reached a stage where individual messiahs like Ravi cannot solve the problem. We need honest people to cut across sectors and network to fight these extremely well-networked and very dangerous corrupt systems.
This,
you know, corruption is like football. People play it like a team sport.
You know,
honesty is like golf. They all play it individually. This is the tragedy.
You know,
I don't think the IAS Association, for instance, has stood up for things like this. This rot has been happening for two decades, Arnab.
I agree.
It's not something that's happened today.
I agree.
It's happened over a period of time.
I agree.
And now we have reached a stage. I hope this is the inflection point. I hope at least now the bureaucracy stands up as one and says that we will not take this nonsense. They did not do it when a chief secretary was suspended in Karnataka 20 years back. They did not do it when a senior officer was jailed about 15 years back. They quibbled over words. And that is a tragedy. Honest people are not courageous. They sit on the fence, they look the other way. And if you find a rare gem like Ravi, who is both honest and courageous, life is terribly lonely for him.
Mr. Raghunandan, I can assure you, this case is not, it's about what happens to a younger generation when they want to serve the country. If someone were to look at this whole case
absolutely,
of Ravi, and
absolutely.
I find it, I find it so sorry here today that here is a man, you demean him, you defame him. You defame him. You try and kill his spirit when he's working. You try and destroy his family. You try and break him down bit by bit by bit, and you don't even have the decency to admit what you've done. The question, yes, Mr. Raghunandan, you were saying something there. Yes, Mr. Raghunandan, go ahead.
No, I can say that when I spoke to him when he was in Kolar, his spirit had not been broken. He was absolutely clear. He said, I will go wherever the government posts me. I don't need any help. I saw in that a lot of strength, but I also saw in that a tragedy. Because I think honest people should reach out and network, because that's the only way you're going to fight corruption in this country.
Mr. Raghunandan, is it fair then for someone like Brajesh Kalappa to come out and said, we were actually encouraging him in Kolar? I mean, the truth must be spoken. He's not here to defend himself.
Rubbish. That's absolute rubbish. Ravi caught 30 acres of land.
Let him speak, Brajesh.
Tank bed, which was being encroached for a golf course. That was a breaking point. And that and the sand mafia, there were very clear reasons. There was a political nexus in Kolar.
You should have said.
No, watch. Can I say one thing, Mr. Kalappa? Mr. Kalappa, first of all,
because you're going to be speaking for me,
Mr. Kalappa,
you're going to have everybody else speaking for me.
Mr. Kalappa, there are people on the show who are speaking the truth. Now, because Mr. Raghunandan is speaking the truth, you think you will stop Mr. Raghunandan from speaking the truth because he's exposing you?
I would have acted.
Well, he will speak, and you will listen. Raghunandan will speak, and you, Mr. Brajesh Kalappa, will listen. Even if you don't want to, you better listen.
No,
Mr. Raghunandan, tell me what was going on in Kolar.
Arnab, let me make one more point.
Listen to him now.
Elsewhere.
Listen to him now.
Arnab, let me make one more point.
Go ahead, Mr. Raghunandan.
I am not suspecting the bona fides of the Chief Minister. Mr. Ravi was working directly with the Chief Minister. If the Chief Minister wants to show serious intent in controlling corruption, let him post another officer in Karnataka, equally honest as Ravi, equally courageous, in the same job and get cracking up.
You said, Mr. Raghunandan, that he was...
Karnataka is not lacking in courageous officers. Karnataka has courageous officers.
Mr. Raghunandan, you said that he was trying to stop a golf course from being constructed. Tell me more about that one, please, specifically. Yeah.
Well, there was a lake bed in which a builder and a politician suspected to be linked to that wanted to construct a golf course. And at that point, Mr. Ravi undertook a check on the encroachment of that lake bed. And that was one of the reasons. That and he's stopping the sand mafia.
Was the politician from
Kolar,
the Congress?
You will even today find heaps of sand. I am not aware of that. I only heard about this, but there was a linkage between a builder and a politician, local politician.
I'm glad you placed the facts fair and square here now. I now want to go across to Mr. Sanjay Bose Reddy on why the IAS Officers Association has not picked this up in a very strong way.
We are in touch with the Karnataka IAS Association. And today they had a meeting in the day. We are still to get the inputs from them. First of all, our condolences, but I would agree with Mr. Raghunandan what he is saying, as also TSR Subramaniam. I fail to understand that why didn't the police commissioner waited for the post-mortem report to see the anti-mortem and the post-mortem injuries? Because once you dispose of the body and you don't go into the anti-mortem, post-mortem injuries and marks, how could you go jump to the guns? But we would not like to jump guns and say what it is. But they should have waited for the post-mortem report and the investigation.
Well, you want to close the case simple.
Carried out.
No, you want to close the case simple. Mr. Reddy, you know what happens in most of these cases. As Rahul Narvekar will corroborate out here, what the politician immediately wants is that when there is somebody who is killed fighting a corrupt administration, the first thing which politicians get together and do is try and close the case very quickly. You know, just first of all, try to delay the case over a period of time and then say we couldn't get the evidence.
Yeah, and then say
close the case, right? And then hopefully bury the case. After all, the man is dead. What is the value of an honest crusader's life, right? Rahul Narvekar?
Well, Arnab, at the outset, I'm absolutely shocked at what has happened in Bangalore, and my
It's not very different from what has happened in Maharashtra over the years.
Family of late Mr. Ravi.
It's not different at all from what has happened in Maharashtra over the years.
Well, I absolutely agree. It's not only in Maharashtra. I've got a list of officers who have been murdered all over the country.
Let's talk about Maharashtra.
It happened in the year 2012 in Madhya Pradesh.
I'll give you the cases. 2010 in Maharashtra.
Right. It happened in the state of Bangalore.
Why are you skipping
Karnataka?
The Maharashtra case?
So there are.
Why are you skipping the Maharashtra?
All over the country.
Okay, so now we
let me tell you, you have this nasty habit. Let me say this. I'm sorry to say this, but you have this nasty habit of generalizing. It's as simple as saying all journalists get indulge in paid journalism, in paid news. It's as simple as that. So don't paint everyone with the same brush.
Right.
Please don't indulge in doing such things, because that does not befit a journalist of your stature.
Have you finished?
Okay.
Have you
and
finished?
Number two, in
now,
so
have
far,
you finished? Have you
so
finished
far,
trying to punch
so far,
me? It's okay.
In so far as
have you finished now? Can I ask? Can you answer my question?
You want me to answer?
But you can't answer a question that has not been asked, Brajesh Kalappa. Now let me tell you what you people did in Maharashtra. Satish Shetty, the case of Satish Shetty, activist. I pick up a case. Satish Shetty, activist, killed in Pune. January 2010, CBI investigates the case, files a closure report citing lack of evidence. Now the same CBI will reinvestigate the case.
Narendra Kumar Singh.
I will give you answers about the mining mafia in Madhya Pradesh. Satish Shetty
in Madhya Pradesh. What about that?
I will give you one more example. What binds all political parties like glue tonight? And this is so ironical that Rahul Narvekar says, I generalize. Yes, I generalize. As far as this subject is concerned, yes, I generalize. Because NCP, Congress, BJP, BJP, NCP, Congress, Samajwadi Party. All the parties represented on this program are the same when it comes to taking on honest bureaucrats, trying to demean them, defame them and destroy.
Ridiculous.
Oh, absolutely.
Ridiculous.
Answer the question about Satish Shetty then. What happened in the case of Satish Shetty? Shailesh Gandhi, what happened?
What happened in the case of Satish Shetty?
I'm asking you about the case of Satish Shetty.
Do you have an investigation report?
The CBI filed a closure
report.
Will you complete my
sentences
for me? Do
you know that the investigation has been opened again?
Yes. Why has it been opened again? Why was it closed?
Do you know about it?
Why was it closed?
So let's not.
Why was the investigation closed? It's not irrelevant. It is very relevant. I want to know. Shailesh Gandhi
is the judge, jury,
yes.
And he decides who's guilty.
Yes, I will ask. Because someone better take you people on. You know, the fact is, the CBI investigated. I'll go base by case. Politician by politician, political party by political party. Shailesh Gandhi, what about the Satish Shetty case? Does it not show that politicians wanted to close the case saying lack of evidence in this case? In other words, another honest person taking on another mafia was killed and an attempt was made to close it. If the police wanted, could they not have found evidence in the case in the first case?
Can I give an alternative?
No, you can respond to him, please, man, because he's making these broad generalizations.
Apart from politicians, etc.
Go ahead.
Since Satyendra Dubey's time, I've been seeing this regularly. Satyendra Dubey's memory was also besmirched by everyone put together. Our flaw lies in the fact that we do not observe the law. Investigations take interminable time. Even if somebody does get caught with proof, the judiciary takes its own time. This really is the root cause of this. Are we aware that in 90 days, the CRPC requires all investigations to be over? Satish Shetty's investigation still continues. And most investigations don't get over in 90 days.
Who was in power all this time?
I am so disappointed that Arnab does not know that investigation is carried on by the investigating agencies and not MLAs and MPs who have been elected by people.
You don't understand. I'm so disappointed, Rahul Narvekar, that you don't know that the police officers report to somebody called politicians who are elected not to cover up for themselves or cover up their own footprints, but actually to serve the people. Now, let me move on now. One minute to the BJP. Because yes, I concede tonight. I am generalizing. I concede guilty tonight to saying, I'm generalizing, I'm saying all political parties together are the same when it comes to crushing the spirit of young idealistic officers, demeaning them, defaming them, and trying to destroy their families. But I warn these politicians tonight, for each Ravi who dies, there are 1,000 people who will go and sit the right the IAS exam and come and take you people on at some point of time. Now to the BJP, and times are changing, watch your step. Do the BJP, my question
shouting
is...
Shouting on top of your voice...
Do the BJP, don't patronize me, I don't need your...
It has not solved the problem.
I don't need your certificate.
The problem is with which needs to be changed.
I don't need your certificate.
We need to establish a special investigation team for officers who are on duty and have been murdered in suspicious circumstances.
Now.
Or have died in suspicious circumstances.
I want to
this
ask
could
the,
be a starting point.
I want to ask
this could
and,
be a starting
by,
point.
And by the way, watch tonight as all political parties take me on for asking questions. Now, the second question is to the BJP. Yes, Mr. Raghunandan wants to say something here. One second, Mr. Raghunandan, what are you saying?
Yeah,
Mr. Subramaniam also? After Mr. Raghunandan.
I just wanted to dwell on your point, and I completely agree that for every Ravi who passes away like this, there will be 5,000 people who will write the IAS exam and want
absolutely
to click on them. But for those people to become effective, you need the IAS associations to become much more than debating
absolutely
clubs.
Absolutely,
you need the IAS associations to become very, very aggressive.
I agree with Raghunandan, because honest people... Boos Reddy should pass a resolution here. Boos Reddy should pass the first resolution here, number one.
Absolutely.
Number two, Arnab, I will also generalize.
Go ahead, please do.
I will also generalize.
Please do, I want
the next elections, tell me how many chief ministers have corruption in their agenda in the top 10 items of work that they do.
Exactly.
So they must now say, please, this corruption as a top 3 objective for you in the next election. You would be judged by that.
No.
Please count which chief minister works against corruption where. Give me one example in any state.
No. I'll give you one example. I'll give Sambit Patra one example. Sambit Patra. Sambit, no, one second. What? Gaurav, I'll come to you also. I'm ready to take all of you on tonight. I want to ask Sambit Patra.
30 seconds.
No. After my question to Sambit Patra. Sambit Patra, do you remember a person called Amit Jethwa?
Gaurav is quite...
Do you remember a person called Amit Jethwa?
Give him the example of Jiaul Haq.
Do you remember, I'll answer the question, do you remember the person called Amit Jethwa who took on BJP MP Dinu Solanki? Do you remember the fact that on 20th of July 2010 he was shot dead by two assailants on a motorcycle? Do you remember the fact, Sambit Patra? Because it is all right to come and talk about, you know, how the Congress party is, its actions have led to the death of DK Ravi. But what about asking you, why did the state government in Gujarat give the BJP MP Dinu Solanki the clean chit?
See, Arnab, the country has the right to ask me questions, and I should not politicize.
No, I am asking you. You failed to protect people in the same way.
Yes,
you see.
Yes. No.
No, how come? No.
Let me
the
answer.
Gujarat High Court said
you.
The Gujarat police probe. 1 minute. Gujarat police probe was far from satisfactory, and it also went on to say that to instill confidence in the people, the case had to be transferred to the Central Bureau of Investigation. Now tell me, please explain your record. All these young crusaders are killed, people who take on the system, and the local politicians just behave like goons, like the mafia out there. What will make up in the case of Amit Jethwa? What right do you have to speak?
The law will have to take its own course.
Own course? The law did not take its own course. Don't give me lectures tonight.
No. If once the High Court has said something, we all
really
have to follow
it. Was
it.
Gujarat? Remember?
My belief is what the Prime Minister says. Na khaunga, na khane dunga.
Don't change it. No, is that the answer we want? Is that the answer we want, Shailesh? Is that the answer we want? That's rubbish. Don't give me lectures. No. He's making an election speech.
Mr. Patra is making an election speech. This has nothing to do with the subject at hand.
10 long years.
Can we rise above this petty politics for once? And can we talk about that person who's given his life? I just wish to say
What, Gaurav? Are you picking up on the Jethwa case? No, we are specific. Are you picking up on the Jethwa case?
I
mentioned the Jethwa case, the killing of Jethwa.
Arnab, can I just say one thing? There was a bill, whistleblower protection bill, been lying in the parliament from 2010.
Yeah.
Nobody has bothered to even pass that bill.
Yeah.
That protects an honest public servant and a person.
The government
and I think
from
it is time that even ordinance has to be brought.
No.
Ordinance has to be brought for an ordinance be brought so that
Gaurav Bhatia, Gaurav Bhatia, what are you talking about? I'm saying tonight, I'm generalizing. I'm generalizing every minute. I am generalizing Gaurav Bhatia. Let us not forget. Gaurav, please. Listen to me. I am telling you, a change is coming in this country. You know how people are calling. I'm going to put them on. No, one second. Let us not forget the case of Ziaul Haq. Let us not forget the case of Ziaul Haq. The IPS officer who was killed in Pratapgarh in March 2013.
The state government immediately ordered a CBI investigation. You are forgetting that.
Yes, the CBI first gave Raja Bhaiya a clean chit, but the special CBI court rejected the closure report in the case that had been filed by the CBI.
CBI investigation was ordered by our state government. We never resisted that.
Okay.
That's why I said that an independent investigation be ordered here.
1 minute. He was Raja Bhaiya. Raja Bhaiya was reinstated. Raja Bhaiya was reinstated as minister.
Please listen to me.
You know, there is a gap here. I'll tell you. Gaurav, listen.
Sambit, you will look at the worst state and then try to portray BJP as a saint. That is not what we practice.
People know what BJP is. But Gunda Raj does not have to preach anyone in this country, remember.
You have made
a Gunda Raj out of Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh is the biggest example of lawlessness today in the whole world. Leave aside India. So the spokesperson from Uttar Pradesh, Samajwadi Party, should not be preaching anyone.
Why was it India
listening?
Why is Narendra Modi
starting his eyes
on the scandal of Uttar Pradesh?
The Bellary case was never referred to the BCBI.
You are more than welcome.
The Bellary case was never referred to the CBI by the BJP.
Rajesh Kalappa, a minute. Brajesh, a minute. Please, Gaurav and Brajesh. Gaurav and Brajesh, a minute. Gaurav and Brajesh, a minute. And Sambit Patra. Sambit Patra, may I please request you to let me come in, please? I am making a point here now. Please listen to me. Sambit Patra, remember, 1 second. 1 minute. 1 minute. I am making a point here tonight. I have never seen a parliament. I have never seen a parliament that has been so out of sync with the sentiments of the people of this country. This parliament did not even bother to pull in a resolution to embarrass Sharad Yadav, who made the most demeaning comments against women. This parliament today has still not taken up the way in which DK Ravi died. It is almost as if we have to coax people. And I'm telling you, all political parties are the same. Sambit, don't speak too much. Because Narendra Kumar Singh was another young IPS officer killed in March 2012 in Madhya Pradesh when he tried to crack down on the stand mafia. You know what he did, Sambit Patra? This young officer, he stood in the middle of the road, said, I will not let the tractor go. The tractor ran over him, went over him many times and killed him. If I open the lines tonight and ask today honest and idealistic young people of this country crushed like this, and we see a parliament here, ladies and gentlemen, which does not even bother to respond to it, not one statement.
It might be my
they are so busy with their own internal bickering and politics.
Not defended. And we have to change. Whichever government it is, I should not defend a wrong in my government also. I will not.
No, no, TSR Subramaniam. No, no, what we have to change. No, no, what we have to. What any other country, any other country, TSR Subramaniam. No, 1 second. TSR Subramaniam. Any other country.
Don't preach.
No, any other country in the world, TSR Subramaniam. Any other country in the world where young people would be butchered like this. This is the price. This is the price you make a young person pay for being honest. Then in that case, have a chapter in every IAS probationer, IPS or probationers, you know, orientation. How to become corrupt, how to serve your political masters, and how not to listen to your conscience. Because when young people listen to their conscience, this is what happens to them. Yes, and
the boiling point has not yet come. People have not yet risen in anger. But the fact is that this country has great young people. I go to Mussoorie every now and then. I find these wonderful coming people coming there. Within 5 years of service, they are given a harsh choice. Become Ravi, fight the system for 30 years.
Yeah.
Turn the other way, be a blind man. Join me, make crores. This is the choice given to them. I am happy to say, very large number of people stand up to the system for 35 years. A large number of people look the other way. Sadly, a few of the brethren are corrupted. Increasingly, that number is going up, and that is the tragedy of India. The great people of India are being suborned by our political system.
Okay, Arvind Deshpande.
I want every chief minister to say now, before elections, within 5 years.
Arvind Deshpande is our first caller and he's calling in from Bengaluru. Arvind, good evening. Arvind Deshpande, good evening, sir. Mr. Deshpande.
First of all, let me salute the IAS officer for his brave response. Now, I am also a victim of many housing societies. Especially, I can tell you, NTI society. It has duped number of persons who have waited from 1984 to get a plot. Coming to Mr. Ravi, see, he was yesterday in the Legislative Assembly of Karnataka. There was a din over Kolar water problems. All MLAs from Kolar, they shouted out. And why did they keep quiet when Ravi was transferred because of sand mafia and sand helps in conservation of water?
When he was transferred, where were the MLAs? Yes, Mr. Raghunandan wants to come in as well. Yeah.
This is exactly the point.
No, let me
this
answer.
This is exactly
that.
The point.
Insofar as Mr. DK Ravi's request for transfer. No, please listen. The father-in-law of Mr. D.K. Ravi met the Chief Minister of Karnataka and made a request for the transfer of Mr. D.K. Ravi from Kolar because he wanted Mr. D.K. Ravi to work in Bangalore. Therefore, the Karnataka Chief Minister took a decision to have
Mr. Raghunandan,
work in his own department.
Mr. Raghunandan.
Work in his own department.
Done. I took your point, Mr. Raghunandan, countering you.
He chose to have him
Mr. Raghunandan and Mr. Subramaniam countering
you. This is the point I've been trying to
make. No, Mr. Raghunandan. Mr. Raghunandan and Mr. Subramaniam countering you. You made your point 1 second.
Why should they counter me? They have no facts.
Let them. Let them.
Please listen to someone else apart from your own voice.
He talked happily of going back to Kolar and working there. I don't think this is correct.
Classic case of making up stories.
This is something which is stated on the Dr. floor Rukmini. Of the house by the Karnataka Chief Minister.
Well, Dr. Rukmini is calling in from Hyderabad. Yes, Dr. Rukmini.
Yeah, hello, good evening.
Good evening.
This is Dr. Rukmini calling from Hyderabad.
Yeah.
Actually, I just want to say Hello?
Go ahead. I can hear you.
Yeah. Actually, every politician on your show today should be ashamed of themselves for trying to defend something so disgusting. All of them should collectively apologize to the nation for trying to defend something like this. How can the Congress spokesman try to back what his government has done? I mean, does he think we are fools? Does he think we don't see through what they are saying? Every system has failed this young officer. The government has failed him. The police department has failed him. They failed to protect him. And the Congress spokesman says he was under the care of the Chief Minister of Karnataka. What protection was given to him when they knew that he was undertaking this kind of work? Huh? And at the end of the day, believe me, even the judiciary will fail him. This case will drag on and on and on. The family will run from pillar to post crying for justice.
Exactly.
Nothing will happen. And I appeal to you, Arnab. You have broken so many scams. You have brought out so many stories so far. Please follow this story to its logical conclusion.
Dr.
Please
Rukmini,
see that the real faces behind this murder. It cannot be anything.
Dr. Rukmini,
a pressure that made him do what he did.
Dr. Rukmini,
bring out the truth behind this and expose these people for what they are.
Dr. Rukmini, I assure you that we will pick up this particular case, we'll follow it, because it just doesn't make sense to me, it doesn't add up. I mean, I've already made the commitment. On top of it, I assure you, we will pick up my reporters. I began the news hour today by saying that starting today, my reporters, my camera persons, my producers, we will be following up at least, you know, as many as we can possibly do cases like this. We'll follow up, because what I find here is the moment the politician and the bureaucrat, this mafia, begins to feel the media pressure is off, they just drag the case and they know how to handle the system. The entire system, you know, is very much within their control. So we are going to take them on very, very directly. So I thank you very much for that, Dr. Rukmini. I thank everyone tonight. I think Mr. Raghunandan wants to make a final point here. And so does you know, I think Mr. Shailesh Gandhi.
Yeah,
and
my, can I just make one point, sir, regarding Manjunath murder case?
My final point is that...
Yeah, go ahead.
My final point is that if the Chief Minister wants to really redeem himself and show that he is serious, he can pick any one of the large numbers of courageous officers in Karnataka, put them in the same job as where Ravi was, and go after these companies with the same vigor that
Ravi
did.
Sir, I'll tell you one thing.
And that will prove that for every Ravi who dies, somebody else to take it.
The Chief Minister is insensitive. Right now, he is absolutely insincere in following up the case. The first person he should take on is the Home Minister. But I don't think he wants to.
Arnab,
can I just say one thing?
Watch. Mr. Subramaniam wanted to come in. Mr. Subramaniam, please. Yes, Mr. Subramaniam. Mr. Subramaniam.
Only one point.
Yeah.
One point. In addition to what Dr. Rukmini said, Arnab, if you can devote just one program once a week for half an hour, on the people do not understand how important corruption is for development, for growth, for all national objectives. One program, half an hour every week, if you can do that, it will keep the pressure on.
I assure you we will. And this entire campaign of action begins here. If you've noticed, first against VVIP racism. And now our movement on failing the honest are consistent movements, not one day movements, not one day stories. We consistently are following it. You see, Mr. Subramaniam, I want to tell you this. We have limited resources too, but I assure you, we will deploy every single available resource to follow these stories. Because what we are doing here is that we are cheating the next generation of this country. We are killing the spirit of honesty.
Yes.
Which is why I appeal to Brajesh Kalappa, Sambit Patra, Gaurav, you know, and Rahul Narvekar. They are the generation next of Indian politics. You also speak the same line as others do. Just because it is your political line, you're letting the next generation down as well. Yes, Gaurav.
We stand united on this issue. We should fight together, irrespective of the political party. And just one more thing.
Corruption.
In the Manjunath murder case, the Supreme Court recently gave its verdict.
No one can,
but that poor man got justice after 9 years and 3 months. We have to ensure that these officers who are honest, who give their life for the nation,
wrapping up, and you know, Karnataka Chief Minister can say on the floor of the house that DK Ravi was transferred to Bangalore at the behest of his father-in-law. Well, I don't know how, you know, even if a request was to be made, I don't know if that is a reason tomorrow for people to get transferred. You know, a father-in-law can't write a letter and a chief minister cannot respond. You know, it makes no sense. You have to have objective reasons that go beyond these kind of issues. So really, we'll investigate this story. It's not the end of the matter. Thank you for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.